Hi everyone, let's talk about fashion. What exactly is fashion? Well, I think everyone knows what is fashion. Fashion is something that is trending right now, or what you're carrying off, or maybe something in trend, something on Vogue, something on runway, or anything. Fashion is okay for you. Obviously, you will be following fashion. You want others to follow fashion. But let's talk about styling. What exactly is styling? Styling, well, I guess you do understand what that is. You know how to carry off your one single pair of jeans, blue denims, with your normal black top or white or something else, or maybe your shirt, and that makes the difference, right? Sometimes you want to carry off those pants for office. Sometimes you want to carry off those pants for just a drink or something else, you don't know. But you can carry them off anywhere and everywhere. So styling basically over here means that you can just carry off one piece with something different every time, as well as some kind of personality that you can carry off with any kind of garment you've been looking forward for. So styling is basically a fine definition of what you are carrying off. Then what would be the job of a fashion stylist? You need to understand that because you want to become one. You can earn a lot with that, by the way. So fashion style is somebody who will actually guide you through what exactly you should wear. It could be your wardrobe, it could be your shopping, it could be anything and everything you want to carry off. It could be your handbags, your headgears, your hairstyles, your makeup, your entire appearance depends on your fashion stylist. The fashion stylist would be the person who would guide you through all the things that your body type requires to be carried off away with, as well as some color tones, some other things that could carry off, that could be carried off well with you. Fashion stylist would be the one who would guide you what you should wear, when you should wear, and where you should wear. Well, what would be the role of fashion stylist in your life? Today I'm going to talk only about wardrobe styling. Yes, wardrobe could be styled. You have so many one-off pieces in your hand, in your wardrobe just kept like that. Oh God, it's just there, doing nothing, just filling your wardrobe spaces and stuff. So what could we do about it? Actually, take them off. Take them off from your wardrobe, keep it aside and see what you can do with it. Try to carry them off, because a stylist would guide you through whatever you can do with those pieces as well. A stylist would help you to be connected with the social life you're actually going to, with the trends which are there, with the new upcoming fashion forward forecasting and stuff like that, which you need to understand so that you can carry off better things. The bags, the shoes, the garments, everything would be there in your wardrobe, but you need to know how exactly you will carry them off. So let's go through it. What exactly a fashion stylist does? A fashion stylist, well, they actually will help you. They will help you go through all your celebrities. Like, you must be a big fan of Ranbir Kapoor, or maybe Alia Bhatt, or maybe Deepika, or maybe Lady Gaga. So you are quite inspired from whatever style they are carrying off. Lady Gaga, for a case, she wears everything exaggerated, very overly done, over embellished, very edgy, very structured. But when it comes to Deepika, Deepika is somebody who would go for a very bouncy silhouette, or maybe something which is very casual, very tomboyish, and you want to carry off things, something like that. So your style is going to be inspired from your celebs. Whatever celebs you like will be the one who will be actually guiding you through to make some difference in your wardrobe. But the stylist would make a balance between what you are carrying off, how your body type is, and how exactly your celebrity looks would look like. Fashion stylist, the role of fashion stylist is very important, of course. But to become one, you have to understand four major types of bodies which generally people have. One could be apple figure, the other one could be hourglass, and the third one could be athlete plus, the fourth one could be and pear shaped. When we talk about apple figures are generally really, really fat, you know. They could be a good build up, but then even if when they are thin, they do have very undefined shoulders, undefined chest line, undefined hip line, as well as waistline. When we talk about these kind of lines, we really need to make a balance like an hourglass figure. An hourglass figure is the figure which is like the ideal one. Of course, we want to be like that. Why not? We want a very nice, natural, thin waist with nice bust line and our hip line. So now what we do according to the different figures we have, like the athletic figure or maybe our figure which is an apple figure or the pear-shaped figure. In all the figures, you can definitely define which body type you belong to. But make sure, whatever big part you have to actually cut that down and let the other thinner part look bigger. To make the balance, we have four major aspects. One is our shoulder line, the other one is our bust line, the third one is our waistline, and then the hip line. We have to show our waistline as thin as possible so that the entire balance is set. In an apple figure, everything should be highlighted on the waist so that the waist looks thinner. But when it comes to pear-shaped figure, we have to actually give highlights onto our upper body, because the upper body is actually balanced, but your hip line is actually bigger than your upper body. But you really can't thin that off, right? Because actually, your body cannot be cut off into pieces. So now what we'll do? We'll actually bring the volume onto our upper body, or maybe prints, or maybe lighter colors, and the darker colors could go down on your hip line so that everything is balanced. But when it comes to athletic body, they don't have anything structured. They're very, very skinny. They're very good also. But then we have to bring out the entire curves in them. And to bring the curves in them, you can use horizontal lines, vertical lines, or some other prints so that everything is balanced and make them look like an R-shaped figure. After we have spoken about the key different aspects of body types, we need to understand the role of a fashion stylist. We are quite updated with whatever body type you have. But then what exactly a fashion stylist needs to learn, except your body type, your wardrobe, and your entire outfit skills, etc. They really need to know about the trends, because whatever is trending right now, you really want to have in your wardrobe. You really want to carry them off. Also, whatever is trending is something you really want to make statement of, right? It could be a pastel color, entire color palette into your wardrobe, or maybe one particular Ted Baker's bag or something else. The other thing you really need to know about being a fashion stylist is known as brands. Brands make a difference, a huge difference. Whatever difference brands make, you know, nobody can carry them off. Right now, if I'm wearing a normal street style, whatever one of pieces from my wardrobe, you won't really be happy with whatever I'm carrying off. But if I post a picture with nice Burberry jacket or maybe Tom Ford shoes, you would be very much interested. Oh, look what she's wearing. And now from that particular shoes, you could be inspired to go and buy something from street as well. So brands do play a very, very major role to understand what exactly style you're carrying off. Then the other thing which comes into our knowledge, being a fashion stylist, is known as fashion events. Oh. Of course, fashion events are very, very important, because you really need to know whatever is going to come in the next few years in your wardrobe and in style and in fashion. Fashion events would actually update you with whatever fashion celebrities, fashion icons are wearing and they would be carrying in the future upcoming years and months.